On Sunday, Delilah Mohammed broke the 400 meter hurdles record for women in the US Championships. She smashed an almost 20 year old record to do that. Now, Nihal Koshi is here with me to explain why this matters.
Press the bell icon on YouTube and don't miss another update.
So, Nihal, why does it matter if a Delilah Mohammed's broken a record in the 400 meter women's hurdles?
The thing with women's athletics, especially in the over the shorter distances, is that these records have been standing for a long time. Like if you look at the 100 and 200 meters record, it was set in 1988.
Okay.
And there even this record dates back to the 400 meter hurdles record dates back to 16 years, 2003.
Okay.
The 400 meters record was set in 85, the 800 meters record in 83.
Okay.
And if records are not broken in sport, it signifies that there's no progress.
Okay.
And on the women's side, with the shorter events, there is a lot of people who watch the shorter events.
Mm.
And unless records are broken and new stars emerge, it is difficult to attract the crowds.
Okay.
So in a way, breaking this record which was set in 2003 is a huge deal, because the 100, 200, 400, 800 records haven't fallen in nearly 3 decades.
Okay, so why is it, I mean, so this record's been around since when then?
Since 2003.
Okay.
And the thing is that this was also a record which wouldn't be broken too soon.
Mm.
So in a way, that is good.
So you're saying like the records in women's athletics have been around for 3 decades in some cases, right? Like, so how does a record like that stay like that? I mean, you routinely have records being broken at all kinds of events. So how come 3 decades?
Yes. That's a good question, because Florence Griffith Joyner holds the 100 and 200 meter records,
mm.
which was set in 1988.
Okay.
So the timings have been so good that nobody's come close to breaking it.
Okay.
And the reason for that being, there has always been a cloud of suspicion over the records in the 80s. Now, Florence Griffith Joyner never failed a dope test. Okay. But in 1989, when they introduced random testing, like now you could ask that how come Ben Johnson was tested in 88? Ben Johnson was a medal winner.
Mm.
In 1989, they started random testing athletes, even those who didn't win medals.
So that means what? You just go.
That there was a greater chance. Yeah. Okay. There was a greater chance of you testing positive.
Mm.
I mean, you being, sorry, not testing positive, but an athlete being asked to come for a dope test.
Mm-hmm.
And in 89, she retired.
Right.
And a decade later, she passed away.
Okay.
Okay. Because of epileptic seizures.
Mm.
So there has always been a cloud of suspicion over her records.
Mm-hmm.
And also the other records, like for example, the 400 meter record by Marita Koch.
Mm.
She has denied any wrongdoing.
Okay.
Nor has she tested positive.
Mm.
So we need to give her the benefit of the doubt.
Mm.
But she is from East Germany.
Right.
And if you know, in the 70s and in the 80s, there was systematic doping in East Germany. It was handed the sports administrators, the politicians, even the secret police, they all worked together to ensure that East Germany bettered West Germany.
Mm-hmm.
And those East German athletes have now come out and are suing the officials of that time. They want compensation from the medical companies. Okay, so this is well documented. The athletes who have come out and said, yes, we doped. So while Marita Koch never tested positive, and she could be a clean athlete,
right.
Like there are a few East German athletes who claim that they never went through the system.
Right.
They were unaware they were doping.
Right.
That is also possible.
Right.
But these records are always looked at with suspicion, because nobody's got close to it. Even the 800 meters record is standing since 1983.
Okay.
That is the thing. The women's heptathlon record
is
another record which was set in 1988.
Okay. So basically these records have just been standing, but you've got also new records being set. Now say like Delilah Mohammed's broken the 400 meter
yes.
record. As of now, she's clean. But I mean, we could be having this conversation 10 years from now and we may be saying the same thing about her record, right? Like
yes.
how does that,
yes.
how do we make, how do we know that's clean then?
So European Athletics in year before last, the European Athletics Federation, they had come up with a suggestion that records before 2005 should be removed.
Right.
The reason being, it was in 2005 that ADAMS, or the Anti-Doping Administration and Management System, was implemented by WADA.
Mm.
By implementing that, it meant that athletes, the top athletes, had to give their whereabouts.
Right.
Basically saying where they will be for a time window every day.
Mm.
So testers can come and test them out of competition.
Okay.
Also in 2005, the records of samples stored were maintained.
Okay.
Means, like, suppose a sample taken in 2005, it can be tested 10 years later with advances in testing technology.
Okay.
So previously undetectable substances can be detected.
Right.
For example, Anju Bobby George silver at the Monaco World Athletics final was upgraded to gold.
Okay.
Because the athlete who won gold later tested positive.
Right. But that was after many years.
Yeah, after a few years.
Okay.
So that can happen. And that is why the European Athletics Federation wanted records before 2005 removed.
Mm.
Because it was after that they started maintaining samples.
Okay. Okay.
Also, like I said, like in 89 is when they started random testing.
Mm-hmm.
So all these, there are question marks over these records.
Okay. So what about the current? I mean, you're saying that it's much better now, but you know, the records in some cases have also been smashed since
yes.
then. Like you've taken Usain Bolt, he smashed what was a world record in 1980,
yes.
90. They're all gone, right? So what does something like that do? I mean, doesn't it put something like that at risk perennially? Like how sort of legitimate are these records then?
See, with regard to Usain Bolt, he's one who single-handedly carried athletics, track and field
right.
athletics, and made it a global sport over the decade.
Yeah.
And his timings are phenomenal.
Right.
Okay, brilliant timings, outstanding timings may never be touched.
Yeah.
At the same time, see, innocent till proven guilty. So Usain Bolt is a clean athlete. He's been tested so many times.
Yeah.
So the biggest tragedy which athletics, track and field can face is that in the future, if Usain Bolt returns a positive test because the samples are stored and the technology improves. But that hasn't happened as of now.
Okay.
So as of now, Usain Bolt is the brand ambassador. He continues to be the biggest star in spite of retiring.
Right.
But you never know what happens in the future.
Okay.
Because like someone like Marion Jones was the last big superstar in
right.
women's track and field.
Right.
She never tested positive, but
yeah.
the investigation into the Balco scandal and the drug she was being administered and the investigation led, she admitted finally that yes, she had taken dope.
Yeah.
So athletics that way is a sport which we could say is a dirty sport. It's a high risk sport, more than a dirty sport, a high risk sport like weightlifting or like even other power sports.
Okay.
So that is always there. That risk is always there.
Okay. So while Delilah Muhammad may have broken the 400 meter hurdle record, the thing is now that it remains to be seen if other records that were set in the 80s and other decades prior to 2005 will also be broken.